Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In this video, you are going to learn how to clean up a panning shot with the paint tool located in the Tools tab. The technique we will go through can be applied to a range of everyday tasks. This includes removing trackers, beauty work, and general shot cleanup. You can follow along with this video by downloading the footage. You will find the link in the YouTube description or type the link displayed in your internet browser. So with a shot like this, I would just like to remove some small but distracting details. And since the shot is moving, we also need to find a way of making any fixes match the camera movement. Let's begin. Switch to the Tools tab and ensure you are looking at the thumbnail view. In the Clip Tools tab, choose the Paint tool. Ensure the expected input is set to front only, as we only have one clip to work with. Click the clip once to select it. Click anywhere on the thumbnail view to set the result clip location and enter into the Paint tool. As always, click Reset All and confirm to flush out any previous settings. Go to frame 1. Now, when using the paint menu with the canvas tools, you are only painting on the frame you currently see. So if you had painted on frame 1 and then scrubbed to another frame, the brush strokes don't carry over. Besides, the shot is also panning. So painting in one location will not work for any frames besides the one you are painting on. So to paint on every frame, as well as track the camera movement, you need to switch to the AutoPaint menu. The default option is always set to Wipe, but you need to change that to User for freehand painting. Now let's set up the brush for cloning. Change the paint mode to Custom, and choose Recursive Clone from the pull-down menu. If you're using a mouse to paint, change the brush pressure to Constant. If you're using a pen and tablet, you can use the pressure setting or also use the constant pressure mode. To the right of the interface, click the Zoom Plus button once. Hold Control Command to pan the image over to the right. So there are three small distractions I'd like to remove: the two bright spots under the ice cream counter and the triangle sticker on the power supply. Let's tackle the sticker first. Hold Ctrl+Shift and the cursor will be ready to sample a clone reference. Position the cursor above the sticker and click down to set the reference. Now move the cursor over the sticker and click down again to set the offset between the reference and where you will paint. But if you want to set exact pixel offsets, just change the X and Y positioning under the brush options. Now hold the Q keyboard shortcut and click and drag on the image to size your brush to approximately 30. Now ensure AutoPaint is in record mode to capture your brushstroke. On frame 1, paint over the yellow sticker until it is cloned away. Now press the play button to complete the recording. The stroke on the screen disappears, but it is recorded into memory. Let's have a look at this recorded stroke. Switch on the animation menu. Now enable Wireframe under the AutoPaint options. Scrubbing the time bar, you will see the red wireframe gradually turn blue. This shows painting over time. This is useful for drawing motion graphics or revealing a stroke. The paint over time is controlled by the second time bar. So it starts at frame 1 and ends on frame 90. If I grab the end frame and pull it down to frame 1, this means the entire brushstroke will be painted on every frame. Next, we need to track the brushstroke to the background. Click the Stabilizer button to enter into the tracking tools. Go to frame 1. In the middle of the image, click and drag the center of the tracking boxes and position them over the yellow sticker. Press Analyze to perform the track. This is pretty simple, and you should be able to get this quite quickly. Press Return to exit the tracker. Scrubbing the time bar, the brushstroke is now attached to the sticker. click the Home button to zoom out the image. AutoPaint will only paint on what it sees in the viewer, so zooming out gives you the full frame to paint on. Ensure you are on frame 1 and press Render. AutoPaint will go through every frame and paint the brushstroke. Please note that I did not do the other areas at the same time because the clone offset needs to be different. AutoPaint can only hold one reference at a time. Secondly, the areas below the ice cream counter might move slightly differently because they are not near the yellow sticker. So once the brush strokes are processed, you can scrub the time bar to check them. Now we can remove the other areas without exiting the paint tool. Go back to frame 1. Switch the auto paint options back to record. Hold Ctrl Shift and set the clone reference to the left of the bright spot. Now remember to click down to set the offset. This time, shrink the brush size to approximately 20. Now paint out both areas under the ice cream counter. When you're done, click the play button to save the strokes. Turn wireframe on again and click the stabilizer button to go to the tracker tools. Click reset all and confirm to reset the tracker. Grab the tracker boxes and place them over the area you need to track. Press analyze to perform the track. With the track complete, press the return button to go back to the paint tools. Still on frame 1, press the render button and smoke will paint on every frame. A few points about this workflow. Tracking brush strokes only works with vertical and horizontal movements. Rotation and scaling is not supported with the paint tool. And finally, you won't need to regrain the painted areas because the paint tool is cloning from every frame. This means that the grain is maintained throughout the clip. Back in the thumbnail view, you will get the result clip that you can load into the player to see the final result. If you would like to see the same challenge again, but using the ConnectFX paint node instead of the paint tool, please click the link now. More paint tool videos will be posted soon showing the workflows with paint. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.